Hi everyone. In this video, we will see when to avoid bupropion. What are the important contraindications of this drug? In which situations this drug is not recommended? And in which situations this drug should be carefully taken? All these things we will discuss in this video. Bupropion is one of the antidepressant drug. This drug is classified as atypical antidepressant, which indicates that this drug is having somewhat less side effects compared with typical agents. Being an antidepressant, bupropion is indicated for the treatment of major depressive disorder. And this drug can also be used in the management of cessation of smoking, as this drug reduces withdrawal effects. But the use of this drug depends on the balance between the benefits as well as the risks associated with use of bupropion. So when the benefits override the risk, then bupropion can be used as atypical antidepressant in the treatment of major depressive disorder as well as in the cessation of smoking. The risks associated with bupropion are mainly specific to the patient, so use of this drug is not equal in all the patients. In few of the patients, the risks may be more pronounced. In such conditions, bupropion should be avoided. First of all, let us see the benefits of bupropion. Since it is an atypical antidepressant, this drug shows somewhat different mechanism compared with typical agents. So this drug mainly acts on the noradrenergic neurons, where it can act on the norepinephrine transporter. So bupropion can inhibit this transporter so that it can inhibit the reuptake of norepinephrine, which increase the norepinephrine levels within the CNS. Similarly, this drug can also act on the dopaminergic neurons, and it can act on the dopamine transporter. This drug can block this dopamine transporter so that it can increase the dopaminergic transmission. So by increasing the norepinephrine as well as dopamine levels within the CNS, this drug can reduce the symptoms of depression. Similarly, the increased levels of dopamine can also reduce the withdrawal effects associated with cessation of smoking. Still, another neurotransmitter within the CNS is associated with depression, that is the 5-HT, serotonin. Now, bupropion is not acting on the serotonin transporter, so that it is not increasing the 5-HT levels within the CNS. This is somewhat different from typical antidepressants. So, this drug is free of serotonergic side effects. Few of the drugs like SSRIs are mainly increasing the 5-HT levels, resulting in serotonin syndrome and other related side effects. Similarly, if you have the drugs like MAO inhibitors, TCS tricyclic antidepressants, they can increase the levels of both norepinephrine as well as 5-HT, and they can also block the other receptors such as histamine, alpha-1 receptors. By all of these actions, these category of drugs produce various side effects such as sedation, weight gain, sexual dysfunction, which are mainly observed with typical antidepressants. But bupropion cannot show these side effects because it is not increasing the 5-HT levels, it is not blocking the H1 receptors, it is not blocking the alpha-1 receptors. Due to lack of all these actions, bupropion is free of these side effects. But still, bupropion is not suitable for each and every population because this drug can produce few of the specific side effects. The use of this drug depends on the patient conditions, any concomitant medication that is prescribed with bupropion, or any risk factors present in the patients which are enhanced by bupropion. So now let us see in which conditions this drug should be avoided and in which condition this drug should be taken carefully. First one is the risk of seizures. So bupropion, when it is given at a high dose such as greater than 300 mg, it can stimulate the CNS so that it can increase the risk of seizures. At the therapeutic dose, this is not that much significant, but when this drug is used at very high dose at frequent intervals, this drug can increase the risk of seizures. Similarly, when the dose of the drug is suddenly increased, again we can observe the seizure attacks. So the dose of the drug should be slowly escalated in order to eliminate any induction of seizures, and even at high dose, this drug may increase the risk of seizures. That's why bupropion is contraindicated in the patients with any existing seizure disorders. Similarly, in few of the patients with any head injury or trauma, or patients having any central tumors, Similarly, the patients with any hepatic cirrhosis, the risk of seizures is more pronounced with use of bupropion. So in such conditions, bupropion is less preferred as it increases the risk of seizures. Similarly, the patients with excessive alcoholism or patients with sudden medication withdrawal, such as anxiolytics, opioids, these drugs, when they are suddenly withdrawn, they can increase the risk of seizures. So bupropion is contraindicated in those patients who are having sudden medication withdrawal, such as anxiolytics and opioids. Similarly, CNS stimulants such as cocaine can also increase the risk of seizures. Again, with cocaine, bupropion is contraindicated. Second one is the hepatotoxicity. This drug can affect the functionality of the liver. It can produce some hepatic impairment, and even it can produce hypertrophy of the liver. So when this drug is prescribed for longer periods, care should be taken to check the liver functionality. And this drug is particularly contraindicated in the patients with any hepatic cirrhosis. Third one is a type of dosage form. Bupropion is available as a normal tablet, and it is also available as SR tablet, sustained release tablet. Similarly, XL tablet, extended release tablet. These dosage forms are not equivalent because they release the drug in a different way. The normal tablet can release the medication immediately, but SR tablets are having a special outer coat which is dissolved. After that, the medication is slowly released. So a slow release or sustained release of the drug can be observed in SR and XL tablets. That's why the normal tablets are not equivalent to these dosage forms, and they should not be interchanged during the treatment. Fourth one is the anorexia nervosa. Few of the patients with anorexia nervosa, they will have increased appetite. So the intake of food is more pronounced due to excessive neuronal activity. This neuronal stimulation can also affect the CNS, resulting in the risk of seizures. So in such patients, bupropion is contraindicated. Fifth one is the MAO inhibitors. Bupropion is an atypical antidepressant, and this drug is contraindicated with the MAO inhibitors. At least 14 days gap should be maintained between the use of MAO inhibitors and bupropion, because in presence of MAO inhibitors, the action of bupropion is increased, resulting in the increased toxicity. Sixth one is the allergic reactions. Just like other agents, bupropion can also produce few of the allergic and hypersensitive reactions. So it can produce pruritus, urticaria, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, angioedema resulting in swelling of lips, tongue, pharynx, and sometimes it can also produce serious hypersensitive reactions. In such conditions, bupropion is contraindicated. Finally, let us see other conditions where this drug should be carefully given. Since this drug acts on the CNS, it can produce few of the central side effects. So this drug should be carefully given in the patients with development of any psychotic symptoms. It can also increase the risk of suicidal thoughts in the young patients. And being an antidepressant, it can also increase the manic phase in the patients. So in such conditions, this drug should be carefully given. So that's about the benefits and risks associated with use of bupropion. This drug is having the many of the benefits. Being an atypical antidepressant, this drug shows very few side effects, and it does not increase the 5-HT levels. So it is not producing any serotonin syndrome and other side effects such as sedation, weight gain, and sexual dysfunction. But this drug may be associated with the risk of seizures or any conditions which are increase the risk of seizures. So in the patients with any seizure disorders, this drug is contraindicated. Or patients with any anorexia nervosa, excessive use of alcohol, sudden withdrawal of opioids and anxiolytics, in all these conditions, this drug is contraindicated. So that's about the contraindications of bupropion. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.